anointed to speak, the ears anointed to hear. I pray that let the word come fast, and nothing can stop the word from penetrating their hearts. I step out for you to step in. Holy Ghost, take charge. Manifest yourself and prove to the devil that you're the master. In the name of Jesus. Someone say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I have titled my message, well, Ephesians, the time is at hand. When it means that the time is at hand, it means that the time is near. It also means that the time is close. And when you say the time is near, it means that how at any given time, the time can be up. Follow me. So we are gathered here today because we understood that there is something not quite right on the roads. If you can bear me witness. But do you know it's a sign that how Jesus is about to come?
Yes.
And the prophecies are about to be fulfilled.
Yes.
So what we're seeing now is the prophetic word being revealed. But you see one thing, before Jesus comes, he's given us the power to stop anything that will bring disgrace to his name.
Yes.
Do you know when people die, God is upset? Because one thing, people have died as millionaires. See, the devil will not attack the young people if they're not gifted. Nobody that goes through battles is an ordinary person. So if we don't pray tonight and stop the killing, your son might be a victim. And you see, the church has become so laid back because they feel like it's outside. Let me tell you something. People that are dying, they're not only gang members. Anybody can get it at any given time. The other day, there's someone that died at 15 years old. He was not a gang boy. But because one thing, the devil knows that if I can stop him now, if I don't stop him now, he will break through. Tonight, I pray for somebody. The devil cannot stop you no more. The devil is working overtime and Christians are working undertime. I repeat. The devil is working overtime and Christians are working undertime. But let me tell you something, if I'm working in Halifax and I'm working overtime or part-time or full-time, the person that works overtime will get the most money. What am I saying? The person that is most serious will win the battle. The Bible says that for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but principalities, powers of darkness in the heavenly realms. So the battle you're fighting, you have to switch from the natural to the spiritual. You have to step out of time and bring it to time. Am I speaking to somebody? Arise and shine, for your light has come, and the glory of God is risen upon you. There is a glory upon your life to impact your generation. You are not a nobody, but Satan has stopped you. But tonight, you are about to rise in the name of Jesus. Time is near. There's no more time to waste. This church is sitting down on their backside and they're praying. Listen, prayer without works is dead. When you pray, make a step. When you pray, do something. The church has become so boxed in and people are trying to be church leaders. But there's people dying outside. But if we step out in unity, there can be a change. There can be a revival. There can be a touch. There can be healing. Shall we? So the power is there. It means that something is happening in the spiritual realm. The time is near. When the time is near, I am conscious how I'm moving. And the people say the time is near, but people are still dragging their feet. If you know what's happening in the realm of the spirit, you will step out there and preach the gospel. If you know that people are dying, do not always report to the government. You take it upon yourself to bring the change. You have some people that know there is something inside them that can bring solution. Say, I am the one. If you rely on the government, they can disappoint you.
Yes.
Because the government the flesh. But we know that the battle is of the spirit. Oh my God. So the battle of the spirit, only spiritual people can win the battle. If the battle is in the flesh, if the government don't speak to the spiritual realm, they will look at it as carnal. But we know that when we wrestle, the weapons of our warfare, oh my God, they are not carnal. We know the weapons that we are fighting with, they are spiritual. So you have to step from the carnal realm into the spiritual realm. And about to pull it down strongholds. So there's some strongholds that are fighting the youth. But tonight, they shall be pulled down. They shall be pulled down. The weapons, son, of warfare, not common. So the weapons means that how you cannot enter a battlefield with a carnal mind. And many people have entered the battlefield with carnal minds. But the battlefield is for spiritual people. So if you're not in the spirit, you will miss what God is doing in this end time. Revival has already started, but the church is behind. But I push them forward in the name of Jesus. The time is near. Something is happening. And if you have a spiritual eye, you can see that how something is not quite right. How can somebody pick up a knife, stab someone, and be happy about it? Something is not quite right. I remember a time when I was a gangster, when I used to pick up a knife. Now I think about it, it was not me. Something pushed me to do it. Yes. And it's a spirit.
Yes.
Because in my normal body, I will not go and stab someone, not that the mom can cry. But when God opens your eyes, my beloved, there is something called an evil spirit. And when it comes upon a man or a woman, he doesn't know any brother or any sister. So that's why you have to make sure you charge your spiritual life, because if you don't charge your spiritual life, you will become a victim of the satanic plans. You will become a victim to the devil's schemes. But the Bible says that he frustrates the craft of the wicked and he destroys their enterprise. The devil is a liar. Tonight, you are about to destroy the wrath of the devil. You are about to destroy the wrath of the enemy. The devil's scared of. If you shut your mouth, you shut your destiny.
It's true. Amen.
Close to the time.
Jesus.
Let me enter scripture. Can you take me to Romans 13? Be really good, please. Come, please. Romans 13. I'll let you go in the next 20 minutes. Amen. The time is near.
Yes.
The time is very close. The time is very close. When I know the time is very close, I am rushing. But people say the time is near, but they're not rushing. Romans chapter 13, verse 11.
Romans chapter 13, verse 11.
Yes.
And do this, knowing the time.
Yes, thank you very much. It's there, so it's fine. But you can still read it from there. I like this church. Try for this church.
And that, knowing the time.
So that's knowing the time. So when I say and, my old grandma in school is that how another sentence has been continued. So what was it before the and? So now, and knowing the time. That now is the high time. Say high time.
High time.
High time means the how. Now is the main time. Now is the important time that the church has to rise up in power and tell the devil that enough is enough. You have grown up before, but you are through us now. We have, oh my God. So
power!
And now, knowing the time, is the high time to wake out of sleep. The church has been sleeping.
Yes.
People are in the church. Yes. They are more important at their position than saving souls. They understand that, oh my God. When the time is now, I wake out of your sleep. Tonight we're going to pray, Lord, wake me out of my sleep. When you're sleeping, when somebody touch you, you are not concerned because you're tired. And the church has become tired. And the devil has been knocking on the doors of the church. But because they are lazy, they don't want to rise up. But the church knows their God. They'll be strong and be an expert. And about saying, God be for you, who can be against you? Tonight, I am praying for somebody that you'll come out of your sleep. You will stop sleeping and stop praying. When it's time to sleep, you will sleep. When it's time to pray, you will pray. When it's time for prophecy, you will prophesy. When it's time for evangelism, you will win souls. Wake out of your sleep, because the devil and his agents, they are working overtime to destroy you and your family members. But the devil is a liar. You can never be destroyed, because God is with you. You can never be destroyed, because God is with you. Wake up from your sleep. They are sleeping. Why? Because they don't have any spiritual life. For when I am not dead in the spirit, I'm awake in the spirit. And when it means wake out from sleep, it does not mean wake up from physical sleep.
No.
Spiritual sleep.
Yes.
Wake up, wake up.
Wake up.
It's telling you that now the church has been dozing off in the spirit. Wake up. Because this afternoon when I read, I said, Lord, it can't be physical sleeping. No, I said, no. The church are spiritually sleeping.
Yes.
And it's more deadly to be spiritually sleeping than physically sleeping. Because when you're physically sleeping, if I pour water on you, you'll wake up.
Yes.
But when I'm spiritually sleeping, you can't hear anything. But I pray for you, may God open your ears tonight.
Yes.
May God open your ears tonight.
Yes.
That you will not be spiritually sleeping.
No.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
For now is our salvation nearer than when we believed.
Yes. So say that now is our salvation. We can have the time is now for everyone to be saved.
Yes.
Yes. And it means that how for now is our salvation. We can have is now the time to get closer to Jesus.
Yes.
Because without Jesus, there's no salvation.
Yes. Yes.
So say that how wake up from your sleep and understand that how. Time is closer than before it was being.
Yes.
So it means that how, if you are sleeping, you can miss salvation.
Yes.